I would now like to revisit this point where I said that this diode should be ideal if it has to effectively bypass the PV cell 2 when it is acting like a sink. In practice, this diode that you would connect is not an ideal diode. It will not have a cut-in voltage of 0 or close to 0. In such a case, will this bypass this PV cell 2? Will the circuit work? So, let us consider for now that this is effectively going to bypass this cell under such condition. PV cell 2 is out of the system, it is bypassed. If you take typical voltages, you will see that the voltage across the source is of the order of 0.6 volts to 0.7 volts. This has to overcome the potential across the load, the VT, and also the potential across the bypass diode as shown like this. This itself is of the order of around 0.6 to 0.7 volts. So this drop 0.6 to 0.7 volts plus VT drop will exceed the sourcing capability of PV cell 1. So effectively this diode will not actually bypass if it is not ideal. So it will work only if you make a diode, the bypass diode, which is having a cut-in voltage of at least 1/10 that of the cut-in voltage of the PV cell. That would make this diode more costly than the PV cell itself. So it is not a workable solution. So the via media is that in between solution is you put the bypass across a cluster of PV cells. Let us say you have some 5 PV cells or 10 PV cells or 100 PV cells in series. So let us say you have PV cells in a module. You can put a bypass for a module, for a cluster of cells. In such a case, this will work. However, note that there will still be issues of negative power within the module, that is within the module, as long as the overall terminal voltage is still positive. So now if you consider, instead of two single PV cells, we put many PV cells in series and we call that one as a module. Likewise, here are many PV cells in series and we are calling that one as another module. So you have module 1 and module 2. Now these two PV modules are connected in series through an external load. Now these can be protected with a bypass diode, because the voltage of these PV cells in series of this PV module will be high. It will be of the order of 35 volts to 40 volts, and it will be much greater than the cut-in voltage of a single diode that you would put in here externally, and that will definitely work. So here I have drawn this bypass diode here, which is bypassing module 2 under conditions when the module 2 starts going negative. That is, the module 2 tube, when it tries to behave like a sink, this bypass diode will effectively take module 2 out of the circuit. We don't know which of the modules are having shading. So therefore, you have to put this kind of a protection bypass diode to every module which is there in the circuit. So you should also put a protection diode across here for the module 1, 2. As you see here, the module 1 is also having a protection diode. Whichever of the module has shading and starts to or tries to go to the sink zone of operation, the bypass diode will come and protect them, effectively removing that portion of the module out of the circuit. However, you should know that within the module there are cells in series, there are no protection diodes. There could be combination of diodes partially having a positive voltage and partially having parts of them having negative voltage. As long as the overall voltage across the module is positive, this diode will not come into the picture. So the internal diodes, if some of them are acting as sinks, they will be dissipating, so we can't help that. At the module level, you can protect it in this fashion. These PV cells in series, these modules, can effectively be represented in symbolic form like this. These are modules M1, M2, MX and so on and so forth, and each of these modules have many PV cells connected in series. And these are the protective bypass diodes, and they are connected across in this fashion such that they protect the modules whenever the modules try to become sinks. If there is partial shading and any one of the modules try to have an inversion in the voltage, these bypass diodes will effectively remove those modules out of the circuit and try to save them from becoming hot, and also to improve the efficiency of the entire overall circuit.